last year and a half, I have been sort of, I don't want to say low-key, it wasn't really low-key, high-key obsessed with making square neck tees and tanks like the one I'm wearing right now. I had been seeing these square neck tees popping up on my Pinterest boards and on websites like Free People, and I just thought they were so beautiful. I love the square neckline. I think it is such a flattering neckline. I also like the idea of it being an elevated t-shirt, which is just basically a very comfortable thing to wear, but it also goes with so many things in my wardrobe, and I knew I wanted to eventually release a pattern for this. So I'm very happy to announce the release of my newest pattern, the Brigit tee, which is a square neck tee that has a partially lined bodice. The neckline is very simple and clean finished with no bindings, which makes it really easy to make. It's a project that you could do in an afternoon, I think, pretty easily. This pattern comes in US sizes 0 through 30 with bust cup options for a B cup, a C cup, or a D cup. And I'll put a link to the pattern in the description below this video so that you can see the pattern on my website, see some pictures of it. I've got size charts and finished garment measurements so that you can check all of the measurements and see kind of what size you're going to fall into. I'm going to be making version A, which is the longer length version of this top, and I'm also going to be making the version with long sleeves. So I have here the fabric that I plan to use. I have pre-washed this, so I washed it and dried it the same way that I plan to wash and dry the final garment. And this is a very stretchy brushed poly spandex knit fabric that I picked up at Joann Fabrics. But in general, you want to pick a fabric that is very stretchy with at least 50% stretch in the horizontal direction. So if you have a strip of fabric that's like 3 inches, for example, and you stretch that and you can get it to 4.5 inches pretty easily when you stretch it, then that is a 50% stretch. You could also use a rib knit that is pretty stretchy, like a lightweight rib knit would be beautiful for this. Even like a rayon spandex fabric would probably work pretty well. That's gonna be a much slinkier knit to work with, but if you are comfortable working with that type of fabric, I think that would be a beautiful fabric for this type of shirt as well. In addition to your fabric, you're probably also gonna wanna pick up some Wonder Tape. So Wonder Tape is a wash away fusible stabilizer. That Wonder Tape is just going to kind of stabilize the edges of the neckline and keep them from getting waffly and wavy when we're sewing those. So I definitely recommend picking up some Wonder Tape or something similar. I also recommend picking up some jersey or stretch needles. Those are just gonna be better for sewing with knit fabrics. If all you have are the universal needles, those are fine too. And then of course you'll need some thread. I like the Guterman polyester all-purpose threads for pretty much every project, so that is what I'm gonna be using on this as well. I'm going to be serging most of my seams to finish the seams, but you can also use a zigzag stitch on a regular sewing machine. That is totally fine as well. I just have a serger. I really like the finish of it, and that is what I'm going to be using. I'm gonna get started cutting out all of my pattern pieces, and then I will meet you back here so we can start putting this shirt together. For this pattern, there are 5 pattern pieces, and those are the front bodice, and this straight edge is the top right next to this little curve for part of the arm side. There's also a front bodice lining, which is basically the same shape except for it is a lot shorter. The back bodice, which also includes the shoulders, and a back bodice lining, which is the same shape as the back bodice, again, just a little bit shorter here. And 2 sleeves. And these pieces will be mirror images of each other. So we're gonna start with the back bodice and right side facing up. Gonna align a strip of Wonder Tape along the back bodice neckline. This is some that I've had for a while, so it's getting a little bit linty on the edges, but it still works great. So you'll see that it has kind of a sticky tape part that's got a double-sided stick to it, and then just kind of a protective strip. And I'm getting that right up against the edge. Once I have the strip of Wonder Tape applied to the neckline, I'm just going to attach the back bodice lining along the neckline, right sides together. Usually kind of start at both of the shoulders, then the center, and then kind of, you know, spread it out along the rest of the neckline. And you want to be careful not to stretch it too much, but if it does get a little bit funny in places, you can always lift it up and reposition it and press it back down. The Wonder Tape is actually very forgiving. And I just want to make sure that I get any of the wrinkles out of the neckline where that seam line is gonna be. Now I can just take this over to the serger or the sewing machine and do either a serged seam or a zigzag stitch along this entire neckline right here with a 3/8 inch seam allowance. Next, I just want to press the back bodice lining away from the back bodice, and that wonder tape is really helping to keep everything nice and stable so it doesn't get stretched out. I'm just gonna understitch right along the edge of that seam on the lining side with a zigzag stitch on my sewing machine. And I am doing a 2.5 millimeter stitch length and a 2.5 millimeter stitch width as well. And understitching is just going to help keep that lining turned toward the interior of the garment and keep it from kind of rolling out and peeking out on the exterior. I'm just gonna fold that along the neckline and give it a good press. So that wonder tape is really going to keep things stabilized so that it doesn't stretch out too much and get waffly. The zigzag stitch is going to allow this to stretch to fit comfortably once that wonder tape washes away. I'll also apply wonder tape to the top edge of the front bodice. So again, right side up. And remember, the top edge of the bodice is the straight edge here with the two parts of the arm side right here that curve into that. Now I'm just going to align the back bodice with the front bodice right sides together. I want to align the seams for those shoulders at the top corners of the front bodice. The back bodice is right sides together with the front bodice, and the back bodice lining, this piece, is on top. Now I want to take the front bodice lining and also align it with the top here so that we sandwich the back bodice between the two front bodice pieces. So this is going to go face down, right sides together with the whole assembly. And then again, I'll go over to the serger and just sew straight across the top, connecting all of that to the back bodice shoulders. And I'll do the same understitching technique by pressing the front bodice lining away, understitching that to the seam allowance, and then pressing it back toward the wrong side. So now you can see we're starting to have the beginnings of our bodice with the front neckline as that straight edge and, you know, the shoulders, the back neckline. You can kind of see where I'm going with this. So now we are ready to attach the sleeves. Now you can baste the arm side together along that front bodice and the back bodice. I'm not going to do that for this one just because this fabric is kind of sticky. I mean, it kind of sticks to itself. So the pieces are staying together pretty well. But if you have fabric that's kind of finicky, especially like a rayon or a slinky knit like that, would be good to go ahead and baste those arm sides on either side just to keep those pieces together while you're pinning on the sleeve. Now, this is my favorite method for putting on a sleeve. I like to put the sleeve on before I sew the side seams. I think it's just a lot easier to install a sleeve that way. So I'm going to lay this right side up so that the lining pieces are on the bottom, and I've got the whole bodice assembly laid flat. I just want to get access to that entire arm side. So once I got that nice and flat, I want to find the sleeve. So the sleeve has notches along the sleeve cap. So double notches indicate the back of the sleeve cap, and a single notch indicates the center top and the front of the sleeve cap. And you'll align those with the points on the arm side of the bodice. So along the back bodice, I've got two notches for the back of the sleeve and a single notch for basically the shoulder, where the shoulder seam would be if we had a shoulder seam. That's where you're gonna align those notches. And then where the back bodice shoulder piece attaches to the front bodice, that's where that single notch on the front of the sleeve is going to align. So first I like to align the underarm portion of the sleeve with the arm side on the front and the back. Then I'll align the center, and then I will kind of work my way in, easing in the rest of the sleeve cap to the arm side. The sleeve is also going to be attached right sides together with the bodice. And along those curves, it's probably gonna feel like maybe it doesn't wanna line up just right. Just kind of keep working it in and kind of, I like to take my fingers and kind of rub the pieces of fabric together until they end up fitting. It should work out just fine. I'm just working my way around, making sure to get all of the edges of all of those three layers lined up together just right, because I don't want to lose that seam allowance when I'm pinning these together. And you can see here how that kind of looks like it wants to bunch up, but as you're sewing this, you know, the seam allowance part of this is actually going to be just right. And because this is stretchy, you can kind of work it in. And then once I have that all pinned, I'm just gonna take this over to the serger and serge along the entire arm side and sleeve cap. Again, you can use a zigzag stitch for this if you prefer, or if you don't have a serger. I'm just using my serger because I like the finish of that a lot better. So I went ahead and sewed on the other sleeve using the same method, and now I can sew the sleeve seam and the side seam. I also went ahead and pre-pressed a hem in the bottom of the bodice and the bottom of the sleeve. This is gonna make it easier to hem the garment once I get that sleeve and side seam sewn together. And one thing to note over here at the side seam of the bodice, there are notches here at the side seam of the bust for easing in the bust at the side seam, especially for the C and the D cups, because those do have a little extra ease in them, and it kind of creates a dart system here at the side seam to do that. So you wanna make sure you align those notches and then ease it in along that portion of the side seam. So now I'm just gonna take this over to the serger and sew with a continuous stitch from the hem of the sleeve all the way to the underarm and down to the hem of the bodice. And I'll do that for both sides. All right, folks, we are almost done with this thing. I mean, we're pretty much done. You could like put it on and wear it as it is. It would be totally fine, but we want to hem the sleeves and the bodice. We've already pre-pressed those, so it'll be really easy to just fold those under and sew those on the sewing machine with a zigzag stitch. You can also use a cover stitch machine if you have one of those. I don't have one of those. You can also use a double needle to do kind of a more professional looking finish on that. I'm trying to decide, do I really want to show that? I don't want to do that. I do have some double needles, but to be totally honest, they're kind of a pain in the butt to thread on the sewing machine. So I'm just going to do a zigzag stitch to finish the hems of this garment. Watching this video, I hope you found this tutorial helpful and that you are really going to enjoy this pattern. I have been enjoying this t-shirt style so much over the last year and a half. I have been wearing it constantly, and now I have a few new additions to my square neck t-shirt collection. So yeah, I also showed a little image in a video a couple videos back of a really neat little sweetheart neckline t-shirt that I was looking at. I think you could really easily do that by just kind of putting a little bit of elastic here in the center and doing like a little ruche here in the center. That's another idea. Another idea that I had, a dress, like a maxi dress, or even like a knee length dress would be really cute for the summer. But I think like a maxi dress with some boots would be freaking adorable. I would love that. I think that would be so cool. So I might end up doing that myself, actually, now that I'm thinking about it. You could also add some embellishments. Like you could put a ruffle in the neckline here if you wanted. I found an image on Pinterest recently that I thought was really cute. And you could even do some fun stuff with the sleeves, like adding in a little bit of a like gathered sleeve at the top to give it kind of a poofy sleeve. Or you could do like a bell sleeve with the bottom of the sleeves, or even like a bishop style sleeve. So there are a lot of options with a very basic t-shirt pattern. I mean, these are things that you could do to a lot of patterns, but I think that those things would stretch that pattern even further. If you've been here for any length of time, you've heard me talk about my love of pattern hacking. So I've also put a link to the pattern down in the description below this video, so you can go check that out for yourself. And if you already purchased the pattern, thank you so much for supporting my pattern business and supporting what I do here on YouTube. I really do appreciate it. I love this stuff. I love providing patterns and sewing ideas for you guys. So anyhow, I think that is all I have for you today. I will see you in the next video. Bye.